Hey all, it's Matt here again from Style Factory. Today, I'm going to be looking at GetResponse versus MailChimp. Stay tuned to find out which one of these popular email marketing tools is the better fit for you. But before I begin, I just wanted to say that if you have any questions about either solution, please do leave them in the comments section. We'll do our best to help answer any queries. Okay, let's kick things off with a bit of background about GetResponse and MailChimp. GetResponse and MailChimp both started life quite a long time ago. GetResponse launched in 1998 and MailChimp in 2001. They were initially conceived as tools for creating and sending newsletters, and they still let you do that. However, over the years, both solutions have become much more sophisticated, evolving into marketing platforms that let you do things like automate your communications, host webinars, accept payments for goods, and even create websites. But which solution is better for your business? Well, let's find out. I'm going to begin the full comparison now with a look at the key reasons to use GetResponse over MailChimp, and I'll follow that up with a look at the areas where MailChimp wins. 1. GetResponse's entry-level plan gives you much more bang for the buck. You get considerably more functionality on GetResponse's entry-level email marketing plan than the MailChimp equivalent. Features you get on the cheapest GetResponse plan, but not on MailChimp's, include fully-fledged autoresponders, e-commerce features, and the option to code your own templates. 2. GetResponse only charges you to store active subscribers. With both GetResponse and MailChimp, the bigger your mailing list gets, the more you pay. However, while GetResponse ignores any people on your list that have unsubscribed from it, MailChimp doesn't. This means that with MailChimp, you can end up paying to store unsubscribed contacts that you can't actually send any messages to. While it is possible to delete these entirely from a MailChimp list, this isn't always desirable, and it involves a manual process too. 3. GetResponse gives you webinar hosting features. A key selling point of GetResponse is that it lets you host webinars, and, depending on your plan, you can even charge people to attend them. This gives you a valuable way to monetize your content and skills. Given how lucrative webinar hosting can be and how expensive webinar software is, this is a great feature to have, and it's one you won't find in MailChimp. 4. GetResponse gives you live chat and push notification features. Unlike MailChimp, GetResponse gives you tools to offer a live chat service on your website and even push notifications. These are features which you'd typically need to use a dedicated product for. As things stand, MailChimp doesn't offer you similar features. 5. GetResponse is much more flexible when it comes to data segmentation. If you want to segment your mailing list data in multiple ways, the sky's the limit with GetResponse. All its plans let you organize your lists the way you want to, and include or exclude segments in a multitude of ways. Oddly, MailChimp is very inflexible in this regard, with full data segmentation options only available on its high-end plans. 6. GetResponse's landing page creator is stronger. Both GetResponse and MailChimp provide users with landing page creation tools that can be used in conjunction with online ad campaigns. However, the GetResponse ones are stronger. Unlike MailChimp's, they provide full split testing features, and they also cater better for GDPR privacy requirements. Okay, so that's 6 key reasons to use GetResponse over MailChimp. But where does MailChimp win? I'll come to that in just a moment. But first, a quick note to say that if you're interested in using either GetResponse or MailChimp, do check out the video description. This contains links to some free trials and exclusive discounts that may be of interest. Okay, so let's take a look at the reasons to use MailChimp instead of GetResponse. 1. It integrates with more third-party tools. MailChimp is a better-known email solution than GetResponse, with a significantly larger user base. Because of this, you'll usually find that integrating MailChimp with key pieces of software is easier than doing so with GetResponse. A lot of well-known applications provide one-click integrations with MailChimp that aren't there for GetResponse. 2. It comes with more e-commerce features. While both GetResponse and MailChimp now come with simple website builders, MailChimp's gets closer to being a proper e-commerce platform than the GetResponse equivalent. Features like product listings, appointment scheduling, tax calculation, and abandoned cart recovery are all currently handled better by MailChimp. 3. It lets you translate content more easily. If you need to provide your e-newsletters in lots of different languages, MailChimp may be a better bet than GetResponse. Unlike GetResponse, it provides dedicated translation features that make it easier to provide local versions of mailouts. 4. Its split testing features are stronger. Although both GetResponse and MailChimp both let you test which version of your newsletters are most likely to be opened and read, MailChimp lets you test more variables. While GetResponse limits you to test performance using subject headers and content, MailChimp also lets you create split tests based on sender names and send times. 5. Its inbox preview options are more extensive. Inbox previews show you how your emails look in various email programs and web browsers, and both GetResponse and MailChimp let you perform these. MailChimp lets you preview your emails in considerably more email clients, however, 50 to GetResponse's 14. So if you're a stickler for detail when it comes to email appearance, you may appreciate MailChimp's more extensive offering here. Okay, so that's the key areas where we think MailChimp beats GetResponse. Now it's time to pick the overall winner. But just before I do that, I'd like to quickly invite you to like this video, hit the subscribe button, and click the notifications bell. This helps us out and gives you easy access to all our online marketing resources. Right, let's sum things up. Overall, we think that GetResponse wins this shootout. The reason is pretty simple. It gives you a lot more features at a considerably lower price point. Of these, its webinar, live chat, and push notification features are worth singling out as features that you won't find at all in MailChimp. And unlike MailChimp, GetResponse doesn't charge you to store unsubscribed contacts, meaning that your monthly email marketing costs may end up considerably lower with GetResponse. The main thing that would nudge us towards MailChimp is its status as a de facto mailing list option. It works automatically with a lot of services that will require a more manual integration with GetResponse. But overall, we feel that despite the fact that MailChimp is the bigger and better known service, GetResponse is the better spec'd and better value tool. I hope you've enjoyed this comparison. Do subscribe to our channel for more resources like this. And finally, a quick reminder that if you need further help deciding between these two solutions or have any thoughts of your own on them, please do leave a comment on the video. We read all queries and we'll do our best to help.